But what I've seen here, it looks like we will do more of the first reason, or I will do more of the first than the second, because the second appears to be. What did you call it? Is it a done deal?
Yes.
The second is a done deal.
Yes.
Well, even if it's a done deal, let me, because it is a serious matter. It's not a Big Brother Nigeria or something like that. It is election, and it's an election to determine the destiny of Cross River State and Cross River areas. So we have to talk about it seriously. Let me ask you a question. Let me ask you a question. Are you happy with the way things are in Cross River State? Okay, let me put it another way. Are you better off today than you were? I know some of you are very young. But are you better off today than you were in 2015? Are you better off today than you were in 2014? Well, the case is very simple. If you take the simplest thing, a loaf of bread, is a loaf of bread cheaper today than it was in 2015? Somebody was telling me in the car the latest price of a bag of cement. For those of you that know, a bag of cement is 5,000 naira today. What was it in 2014? So let me ask you a question. So why would somebody leave the PDP and go to the APC? What on earth would make somebody elected on the platform of the PDP move to the APC? Does it make sense?
No!
So, what is our mission in 2023? Our mission is to take our state back from the APC. We have to take our state back from the APC. Because if APC was good, all of us would say it's good. But it's not, they're not doing well. So our mission in this state is to take our state back from the. And that is why all that argument, all those things that people have said, Attah, Basiyawan have said, that is where it comes to play. We must put our house in
order.
We must put our house in
order.
Because if we don't put our house in order, how will we take our state back? Does it make sense?
No.
But I'm making sense.
Yes.
You are understanding me?
Yes.
With the flow.
Yes.
So, how will you take your state back if your house is not in order? If we are doing things that we are not supposed to do, well, let me not go too deep. I know that there are issues of unemployment, there are issues of healthcare, there are issues of capacity building, there are issues of security, and so on in this state today. What non-payment of salaries, a depleted civil service, pensions and gratuities, all those issues are plaguing us in this state today. We need a governor that can solve those problems.